Hello, YouTube's Krosama, and here we have today from the Frame Arms Girl line is once again the Stiletto. So this is the AIS color, and I basically just kept the color scheme very close to the same exact color scheme as you see right there. Mostly what I just did is, you know, kind of add a little bit different color tone of the red, and that's really about it. The black is still black. Still kept the blue, kept a lot of the red the same, and you know, it's not really much different from what the stylet on the cover art is. But once again, I did do a little bit of custom to it, so we'll take a look at that. But regardless, you know, I really enjoyed this build, and I've had this kit in my collection, I want to say about 10 to 11 months before I pulled it out and started building it. Especially like the build custom parts, I had this exact custom, you know, planned, but I just never got around to it. So thankfully, Zachary Aurelius, he had a little contest that just concluded, and it was the Kotobukiya contest. So basically you had to build a custom, or you just build anything from the Kotobukiya line and submit it, you know, 5 pictures, and you know, you do what you want to. If you want to straight build, cool. If you want to do a diorama, if you want to paint it, whatever you wanted. So I was like, you know what, I definitely would like to paint mine. So that's exactly what I did, and I think it came out pretty good. So let's take a look at some of the things on this kit. So as the critic I am, I'm definitely gonna point out some of the flaws I've made on this kit. So, some are super, super easily repairable that I just never got around to it. And then some just, you know, I would have to like strip the paint and redo it. But the first thing I want y'all to take a look at is going to be the top of that forehead. And you see where that little decal is? Yeah, I apparently accidentally knocked half of that off, so it looks like it's already like starting to peel off. And the funny thing is, I put a setter on there, and once I let the setter dry, I did put a top coat, and for some reason it's still, that one particular one did not want to stay on. All the other decals look perfectly fine, but this one in particular, the top one, just did not want to stay on. So that's the only little issue I really have with this decal. I don't really know what was wrong with that. So maybe I didn't let it sit on there long enough, or maybe I don't know, maybe I didn't do as good of a job with the top coat. But regardless, you know, maybe peeling off, I'm probably just gonna take it off completely and just replace it. I have the exact same decal, so I can easily swap this one out for a better, more conditioned one. So I just wanted to point this out before I do it, because, you know, I'm a flawed builder, and I don't want y'all to think that you know, everything I do is perfection, which is definitely far from the truth. Another spot I really think I'm very weak at is shading. So as you see right here, I did my best attempt at shading for the first time, and it didn't, to me, it just did not come out great. It's very like inconsistent. You know, at the little tip right here, it looks pretty decent, but when you go more towards like the middle and at the bottom, I think it looks really inconsistent. It's very light in some areas. It's like a dark spot in some areas. So it's probably a combination of my airbrush pressure, because I don't really have a great airbrush. This is more of a beginner's airbrush, and I really try to do some of these advanced techniques. Now, granted, I could use the technique I've always used, and that's the pastels. But I decided to do the airbrush kind of approach, and it just did not come out that great. It's fairly noticeable, so I know that's going to be a hit on me when the contest concludes and they start doing other judging. But you know, let's just go ahead and move on. So my next little problem, and I'll just kind of go more into the overview of the kit itself, but this little issue I had is not really much of like a problem with the kit or anything. I didn't add enough color. I think that maybe choosing that darker tone red, which you can see this right here and this is a red wine color, so you can definitely see the noticeable difference, and then this is a red matter. So it's very bright. I think it's really good. But then you go over here and this is a little bit, it looks a little bit more pinkish, which I actually really liked. I think it had a good overall theme, and you know, it's a very red suit, and I don't think that's a problem, but I definitely should have added more color instead of relying on the decals to do the color separation for me. Now, I did add some silver right inside there, which I think it came out okay. There's a little bit blue right here on the actual knee parts, and then the thrusters are silver, so there's a little bit of color in there, a little bit blue on the corner tip of the little fin, the little stabilizer. But you know, I really just should have added something else. I think I should have painted the inside of this maybe black or something, maybe inside these little areas. I'll kind of zoom in a little bit. So inside of here, I definitely should have added some color. I don't know what I would have added, maybe some white. I think white would have looked pretty good inside here, because the white overall, I think, contrasts very well with the red. So that was kind of like my biggest issue, is just I should have added more into this. I was already at crunch time, and I finished this kit the night before the contest concluded. So after I finished everything, I was like, you know what, I don't even want to touch it anymore. I put the top coat on and I was like, it's done. So yeah, overall, you know, I think I could have did a little bit more with the legs or with just the overall kit itself. But I was just kind of like, meh, you know, it's one of those things I know I wasn't going to win, but I had a great time building, and I think that's what mattered. So instead of me kind of like being very, you know, try hard, just so, you know, I want to make sure I win, I want to do everything in my power, I was more like, let me learn some new techniques. So I learned, you know, how to do the shading, and I learned just some more of like the little custom parts and everything on how to do that. So that's pretty much about it. Now I'm gonna go through some of my positives right before I go into like more looking at each individual section of the kit. So some of the positives, I think I did really good when it came to the hair. So what I wanted, I basically did a white, you know, a plain white color on the hair, and then I went over it with some pink. Now when I went down here, I do have a way to lower the pressure a little bit, so I lowered the pressure and I basically try to give it these like white tips right here if it wants to focus in on that hair. But yeah, I gave it basically these like, you know, white tips, and I think that came out much better than what I was thinking. But in retrospect, I probably should have like chosen a better color, and I really am trying to focus on this for y'all. But yeah, I basically wanted the white down here to be a little bit more, you know, just highlight it. And I think that came out pretty well. And I even did it for some of the individual strands, like there. So yeah, basically just pink. And then, going further down, you see more of the white. So pink. And the pink I chose was, it was just a normal pink. I don't think it was like a fluorescent or anything. I think it was just very, very normal pink. And to me, it looked good because I chose pink eyes. And I was like, normally your eye color kind of corresponds to your hair. I mean, obviously not all the time, but I think for 9 times out of 10, the hair usually matches the eyes. So that's exactly what I wanted. I was like, I got pink eyes, so I'm gonna get pink hair. Now, one good thing I actually believe I did was putting the silver underneath my blue. I used a metallic blue, and I actually hand brushed it. So I put some chrome right underneath it, and it was only for this little area on the chest that I did it. And it's super, super bright, especially when it hits the light at the exact moment like this. It looks like it illuminates. So I truly, truly love that I did that. And I kind of wish I did that for all the other blue around the kit. But I kind of just kept it more like, you know, it just normal metallic blue everywhere else. Definitely should have did it down here. I don't know why I didn't. But right there, I think it looks super good. And it kind of just, I don't know. It's to me, it's like an Iron Man kind of look. Like, you know, Iron Man has his center chest that illuminates, and she's also going to have her chest that illuminates like that. So for the backpack, I decided to choose the MSG parts number 11, and I instantly got sold when I looked on the back of it and I saw the stylet already rocking them as wings. Granted, they were upside down, so I was like, you know what, I really want to flip these and have it more like a fairy look. So I think I did choose the best route. To me, it looks super, super good this way. But yeah, I had to do just some masking for that red because these are not separate parts. It's basically two parts that are split in half. You slap them together and bam, now you have the wing part. So I did have to do a little bit of masking, but I think overall it did come out pretty damn good. So for the legs, I actually chose the MSG number 18 parts, and I just absolutely loved them. The only problem I did have is just the fact that they didn't work well with the legs. And you can kind of see right in there, you're gonna see a little peg. And the only way I can eliminate this is by shaving these little parts up here. So it was not a flush little area, and honestly, I was like, you know what, I just don't want to go through the problem. And in hindsight, I really should have just shaved that completely down. It was a little bit hard to see, but these like kind of protruding areas, that's what's keeping the leg from going all the way inside. So whatever reason I had, I didn't just, you know, shave it all the way down to where it's flush, and it could have been, you know, completely nice and leveled, and you wouldn't have that gap. So I mean, after all, I just kind of just said whatever, and you know, it's not a good thing. I definitely should have actually put the effort in and shave those pegs down so that way they wouldn't have that big old gap right between the actual flesh colored leg and the, you know, more weaponized leg. Now overall, I actually really do like the way the legs look, even with the colors that, you know, are kind of more predominantly red. I actually really like it. It has a Gundam EXS kind of vibe to it, especially with the knees. I thought that just looked super, super cool, and that was one of my main, predominant reasons for getting these legs for this custom. I thought they looked cool, and I honestly don't regret them, and I could have done a lot with these. I think I could have probably either added to it, or I probably could have maybe just changed the shape a little bit, but, you know, I think they look perfect. I think this was exactly what I imaged it in my head with, you know, the colors and everything. So it came out exactly how I was imagining it. And I think that's the most important part is, you know, making your vision comes true, even if your vision is flawed. But, you know, you can kind of see your flaws right then and there. So once again, I'll do a little bit better. Now with the eyes, I did find some custom eye decals, and I found a whole bunch of them. But the ones that were pink kind of just stood out to me. So I snagged those up when I was out there in Hiroshima, and I think they look pretty damn good. And kind of just overall has a very good look with the kit. So very happy about that. I don't really have much else I can add to it. The black is just a flat black. I did use a little bit of gray, if you can see that in the arms. There is a little bit of gray on this kit, which I don't think was originally on the kit in the first place. I think it was actually more of a very like bright tan. I used a little bit of black. The flesh color was actually called character flesh. But it looks a lot more white to me. Definitely not as white as the actual flat white I use for that collar, but regardless, it's a little bit too white for my taste. So I think I'm gonna try and pink it up a little bit. So I might add a little bit of pink to the color whenever I'm, you know, mixing it in into the bowl before I start adding to the airbrush. That's probably what I'm gonna be doing. And next, I want to go ahead and showcase the MSG number one weapon system. So this is just a very, very huge, huge cannon, as you can see. Definitely is much taller than the actual kit itself. I loved it, and I used just basically a light gunmetal and a normal gunmetal for it. So you are going to see those two little kind of contrasting, you know, colors. So I used like a little bit of light for the back of it, and then I used mostly neutral, and then I kind of mixed it in with a little bit of silver for like the little hilt right here, if you can see, or the little arm guard. And then down here for the magazine. But for the rest, you know, once again, this is another thing that is much like the legs. I wish I would have added more color to it. But this was actually the last thing I've painted. So when I finished it, I was like, you know what? I was like, it doesn't have enough time to cure, and I really didn't want to start, you know, doing a lot of things to it while the paint was fairly fresh. So I was like, you know, I'm gonna just chalk this up as a loss. But there was a lot of color I did plan to add in there. I was gonna do a lot of like, you know, gold and bronze trimming, as well as a little bit of red, then do some like little chrome here and there, and maybe some slight weathering. I was gonna do dry brush weathering, but you know what? It still looks good, and I think with the overall kit, if you kind of like pull it back a little bit, you know, it's still perfect. It definitely just added to the overall theme I was adding, that I was trying to go for, was a very heavy weapon, heavy mobility, you know, frame arms girl. So definitely is what I, you know, envisioned, and it came out beautifully. So my final thoughts on this kit, I can definitely tell you with full confidence that I'm very satisfied with it, even though there's quite a few flaws, some that are easily repairable. So like the decals, a lot of those I can fix, or, you know, the color to certain areas, I can actually just technically fix it now. I really don't want to paint over a top coat, but that shouldn't be any kind of issue. I can just, you know, put a little bit of detail paints in certain areas, and it should come out pretty damn good. But that's really the biggest things. You know, I already mentioned, you know, what I was lacking on, and then I also kind of showed some of my strengths. So I'll definitely improve on the shading, and I think that's going to be a technique I'll continue to use in a lot of my future builds. I should have maybe done a little weathering to this kit. I think a little bit of silver and black here and there would have done wonders, and I think it would have made it stand out just a little bit more. But I was actually a little worried, and you know, it was already crunch time, so I was like, you know what, I'm not gonna do it. I was like, I'm very much content with how it looks right now. So I definitely skipped the whole weathering process, and you know, maybe in hindsight I should have worked on this kit maybe back when the contest was first announced, but I don't know. I was very much procrastinating, so let that be a lesson to many of you. If you're building and you have a contest or you have a due date, just go ahead and get started on it, because you don't want to be that person that's, you know, doing the rush time and then you start having regrets, much like I am. So, you know, overall, it does look pretty good. I personally enjoy it. I'm going to proudly display it on my shelf. And I think it's going to stand out amongst all the other Frame Arms Girls kits I have, mainly for the fact that it is painted, so that does make it look a little bit better. But that's really about it, guys. I don't really have anything else. You know, if you have any kind of questions about this kit in particular, definitely ask me in the comment section below, and I'll answer you as quickly as I can. But that's pretty much all I have on my end. You know, if you did enjoy this review and you did enjoy the overall build, please let me know in the comment section below, and I'll definitely get to you. If you do have any kind of critiques, please let me know. I'm very much open to it. Now, obviously be tactful. Don't just kind of like, you know, say, oh, it's a piece of shit and that's about it. If you do have any kind of critiques, please let me know a solution. So if you say, hey, you know, your shading wasn't that good, but here's a solution how you can get better, or here's a tutorial, I'm always open to that. Open criticism is something I'm very much strong for. But that's about it for me, guys. Definitely thank you for watching, and I know I've been posting a lot of work in progress pictures, so all the ones that have been giving me encouragement through that time frame, you know, definitely appreciate all your comments, whether it be on Instagram or it was here on YouTube. Definitely appreciate everyone. So I'm gonna get back to videos. I gotta start making the narrative. I gotta start making the Ultra Instinct Goku. I gotta start pushing out this content for you guys. So definitely stay tuned for a lot of that. And you know, like always, like, comment, subscribe if you have not already. And I'll be seeing y'all in the next video. Bye bye.